is the objective of cost accounting? First is to determine cost, which is ensure costs are assigned to respective department in organization. Each department will be responsible on the cost which have been given or allocated to them. Next is for planning and control. We set and prepare activities, target or goals, and compare between actual cost and budgeted cost, and enable corrective action to be made. And finally, for decision making, cost information will assist manager or person in charge in decision making purpose. Next, we go through on the costing terminology. First is definition of cost. Cost is defined as the expenditure incurred in producing a product or a service. The assessment of cost by applying accounting and costing principles, methods, or techniques, it may be determined after or before the costs are incurred. Next is cost object. Any activity for which separate measurement of cost is desired. Okay, we refer to the example. Let's say cost of manufacturing a car. The cost object of this definitely a car. So we identify any cost related to manufacturing a car. Next is service cost of rendering a service such a hotel. So the cost object is the hotel. So we identify any cost incurred in service hotel. How to do costing? Costing involves collecting and classifying expenditure according to cost element. So what is cost element? Whether it's a material, what is the labor and the overhead incurred. After we identify, then assign the expenditure to the cost center or the cost unit or both. Next is a basic term in costing. So first is, what is cost? Cost is amount spent or used on making product or doing an activity. It must be in monetary form. Example, RM10, £5, 1,000 yen, regardless of the currency. So it must be in monetary term. Next is cost unit. Quantity unit measurement of product or service where cost can be related. Example, in sugar, cost unit for quantitative measurement of sugar is kilogram or gram. So the cost unit is centimeter or meter. Petrol, so the cost unit is liter. So this is the cost unit, which is quantitative unit measurement. Next is cost center. Cost center is a business section or department where cost can be charged. It can be classified into process cost center, production cost center, and service cost center. Process cost center is where specific process or continuous sequence of operation is performed. Example, input processing manufacturing company, the cost center are mixing and cooking department. For example, in making a bread, we must mix the ingredient, then we can cook. That is involved process. We cannot cook and then mix the ingredient. So it must follow the process. Next is production cost center. It's involved in making or manufacturing product. For example, machining, mixing, cutting, assembly. So it can be producing different parts of the product. Then we assemble. For example, in car manufacturing, we produce the body of the car, mirror, tires. Then we assemble each part to make a unit of car. So that is a production cost center. And finally is service cost center. Provide support and service to production department Example, maintenance department, canteen, and store. So these are the support need. Next is profit center. It's a unit within an organization whose manager are accountable for both revenue and cost. Basically, revenue minus with the cost and get the profit. So that is a profit center. Next is investment center. So unit whose manager are responsible for both revenues and costs, and in addition have responsible and authority to make working capital and capital investment decision. Working capital basically refer to current asset and current liability, such as how many inventory, cash in hand, cash at bank, or our account receivable, debtors, and current liability refer to our account payable, maybe we have loan and so on. So these all decision relate to current asset and current liability. Capital investment decision, which is refer to for example purchasing of non-current asset, this is a decision that involve a huge sum of money. So that is capital investment decision. And next is cost classification. Basically we have based on nature or element, which is whether it's classified into material, labor, or expenses. Identifiability or traceability, whether it's direct or indirect. Next is behavior, which is how cost or revenue will vary with different level of activity or volume. Based on function, which is cost by function to which they relate to. Based on controllability and also normality. This is based on nature or element. It divides into material, labor, and production or manufacturing overhead. Material meaning that cost of ingredients or element or basic parts in making a product. Okay, next is labor. Cost spent on person who is responsible in changing or transforming the material into product or finished good. And finally, production or manufacturing overhead, which is cost indirectly incurred in the process of changing the materials into a product. Example in the bakery shop. So let's say in making a bread. So material is, for example, flour, eggs, butter. So this is the material. Labor is the person who make the bread. For example, the cooker, chef, and so on. And finally, production or manufacturing overhead. Example is electricity, rental of the shop, water bill. So this is the overhead. Based on identifiability or traceability, so it divides into direct cost and indirect cost. Direct cost, we have direct material, direct labor, and direct expenses. Next is indirect cost. We have indirect material, indirect labor, and indirect expenses. Okay, what is direct cost? Cost that can be directly identified to the cost unit. So direct cost, also known as a prime cost. Next is indirect cost. Costs that are incurred in the process of production but cannot be directly identified to the units produced. Indirect cost meaning that it is a overhead. Essentially, prime cost and overhead are required to produce a product. Direct labor plus with the manufacturing overhead, also known as conversion cost. Conversion cost is the cost to convert raw material into finished goods. We refer to the example, let's say in dress boutique. Okay, so first is direct material. Direct material is a cost of basic element involved in making a dress. Definitely is cost of the fabric in making a dress. So the cost of the fabric is a direct material. Next is direct labor. So direct labor is a cost spent on person in making a dress. Example, salary of dressmaker or tailor. So when it's cost incurred, spend on person, then is a direct labor. So next is direct expenses. Are those can be allocated to a unique cost unit or center of a boutique business. Example, hire a special sewing machine for dress. Okay, example, in order to make a wedding dress, we need to rent a special sewing machine. So the rental of or hire of cost of the sewing machine is considered as direct expenses. Why it is a direct expenses? Because we can't make the dress without the sewing machine. So that's why it's a direct expenses. Okay, next is we refer to indirect material. It's a cost of dress as needed to make it complete, useful, look nice and sensible. Example, cost of accessories, ribbon, button, zipper. So this cost is indirect material, meaning that without this, we still can make the dress. So that's why it is indirect. Next is indirect labor. Indirect labor is a cost charged on a person who is indirectly involved in a boutique business. For example, salary of sales girl, salary of cashier. So they are not making the dress or the product, but they are involved in the business. So this is indirect labor. And finally is indirect expenses. Those cannot be allocated to cost unit or center, but have to be apportioned to the cost unit or center of boutique business. Example, rental of shop, utility bill, depreciation, rate and insurance. So this is the indirect expenses.